Good morning. Wow, that's loud. Oh, it's so good to see all of you in worship this morning. Thank you for being here to be a part of our time together today. We pray that God's Spirit might be at work among us, calling us, beckoning us, also comforting us and challenging us as we walk into this time of worship today. And I thank you for being a part of it. We especially welcome those of you who visit with us today. We're honored by your presence. And also those of you who join us online. We're grateful that you're here to worship with us as well. Number of things that are happening here at the church, just a real quick recap of the things that are there in your bulletin. One is that this month's mission of the month is the South Main Mercy Center, and we continue to have a strong relationship with the work that they do there. So please be in prayer for that ministry and their ongoing work that they do at South Main. There's some information about that in the bulletin, and if there are ways in which you want to get involved in that ministry there, we have several people here that will be happy to have a conversation with you to tell you about how you can help in a special way. Of course, our clothes closet continues its operations unabated, and donations can be made and those things that they have for the summer that are coming up. Please be mindful of that and see if you can help with that. Also, our It's for the Girls project, they've been meeting, they met this past week. They got another one coming up on April 16th. That's Tuesday, isn't it? Yeah, I believe so. Okay, yeah, Tuesday. So that's just really, really important parts of what we do here, and hope that you can volunteer for those and or donate to them as well. And also there's an announcement in here concerning Realm Connect. That's a feature that we have within our church whereby you can get information. Also, we can have your information that might be shared with those who are within the congregation, and it's a database that helps us to manage the people's information here at the church. But you do need to sign up for that in order to partake in that, and if you would like to do so, give us a call at the church office so we can lead you through that. It'd be helpful if we had that database for us to be more user-friendly from our side. So, and also I wanted to say a word of thank you. I know that we have Jennifer's here. We had volunteers for the Rebuild Upstate project yesterday. Thank you all for your statement to our community and your involvement in that. We're thankful we had an opportunity to be a part of that. All right, let's begin our worship of God today. Thank you.
and of faith. There is one God, and there is one mediator, Jesus Christ, who came as a ransom for all, to whom we testify. Saying, sure and worthy of full acceptance, that Jesus Christ came into the world to save sinners, and was manifest in the flesh, vindicated by the Spirit, seen by angels, proclaimed among nations, believed in throughout the world, taken up in glory.
Thank you. Please be seated. Let us go to God in prayer. Lord, we thank you that your Holy Spirit invited us into this time together and has welcomed us into this time of worship. I pray that you cleanse our minds, our souls, everything about us so that we are able to hear you speak and able to feel your presence in this place through the work of your Spirit. We're so grateful, Heavenly Lord, that we have been brought safely through this, a busy week, filled with so much mundaneness, many trials, filled with so many things that we had to do. And we are grateful, dear Lord, that we have survived that. We are also grateful, dear Lord, that you have given us, even in the midst of such busy times, to know that we could and should be about the work you have set before us. I'm thankful, dear Lord, for the ways in which that's been able to be accomplished here at this past week and in the way that community. And I pray that we might continue to do so in an important and powerful way. More importantly, however, Lord, I pray that you here go through this Easter season, that you remind us that it is the news, the resurrection of Jesus Christ as the firstborn from the dead, that shapes, mold, and changes everything that we do. So let our work, our missions work, be more than just that. Let our presence in the community be more than just that. Let our time together and our fellowship be more than just that. I pray, dear Lord, might be a sacrifice before you because they're focused on the beauty, the power of what the resurrected Christ means for us. We are beyond thankful for how that shapes who we are. We're beyond thankful for how that molds what we have to say to the world. We're beyond thankful for what that means for us in our personal life, what it means for us as a community of faith. For here we talk about the things of eternity, not simply the things that make us to get along better every day. We are in prayer for our brothers and sisters who this day have experienced pains that are through periods of suffering, those that are going through seasons of grief, those that we know of within our church and those that we know who are outside of it, hospitalized, those who are in other care facilities, those who are doing rehab, and those who are awaiting tests to know where their health will head. For all these things, we lift these people up in prayer. So one of the several folks here in this place this morning who I know their presence here is to your grace and to your healing touch. We're thankful for that, dear Lord, but we pray as well that you continue to be with those who aren't in our presence today to give them that which they need, whether it's healing, whether it's comfort, or whether it's a new hope in the midst of a season of trial. For these, dear Lord, we make special prayer. We long for them to have power at work surrounding them. And so we pray, Father, that you may answer our prayers that we make for them. for all the prayers that we make in the name of Jesus Christ today. Together, the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.